I'm TJ Manotok and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin with a commemoration of Memorial Day in the U.S. A wall with over 500,000 poppies was put up in Washington, D.C. to remember fallen U.S. service members. The wall, spanning 133 feet, is filled with 645,000 poppies, with each flower representing a U.S. personnel who died serving since the First World War.
Well, we all consider Memorial Day the advent of summer. It's usually comprised of backyard barbecues and mattress sales. And while it's important for Americans to enjoy their lives during this holiday weekend, we want to ensure that they just take a moment to reflect on the true meaning behind this sacred holiday, and that is the enormous sacrifice of men and women over the course of our history that have brought those freedoms to us.
U.S. President Joe Biden will lead the commemoration at the Arlington National Cemetery in Virginia. He'll be joined by the Joint Chief of Staff Chair General Mark Milley, along with Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin. Meanwhile, in Canada, veteran Filipina journalist Carmina Constantino vows to keep pushing back against disinformation. The anchor for the ABS-CBN News channel visited major Canadian cities as part of her 2022 Marshall McLuhan Fellowship.
Who wouldn't be inspired by that, knowing that for every question or every challenge that you pose, that you have your country and your family in your heart and in your mind? So that's what's keeping me going.
We will continue to hold the powerful to account for the disinformation, for the funds lost to corruption, because that is our job.
And finally, in sports, Filipino boxer Melvin Jerusalem fails to defend his WBO world title against his Puerto Rican contender Oscar Collazo. The Bukidnon native lost via technical knockout during Saturday's match at the Fantasy Springs Resort in Indio, California. Jerusalem shares he had difficulty fighting in the U.S., having arrived stateside just this month. Despite the heartbreaking loss, Jerusalem says he's determined to redeem himself soon.
Ngayon, relax muna, pero babawi talaga ako. Kasi sayang yung panahon. Sayang yung time ko. Sayang yung pagiging champion ko. Hindi ko na-defeat saan. Sa Pilipinas, masinja po, kasi lalo tayo. Binigay ko yung best ko, pero hindi na ako makagalaw nung ilang round.
While he lost the belt, Jerusalem gained some valuable experience. At only 29 years old, he's expected to come back better and stronger the next time he steps in the ring.
And those are our headlines for today. Catch more of our TFC News online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manotok. Stay with us, Kapamilya.
I'm Henny Espinosa and this is your TFC News Now.
Hollywood led the charge as thousands of union workers marched the streets of downtown Los Angeles this past weekend. The Writers Guild of America, which represents television and movie writers, has been on strike for nearly a month as they continue negotiating with studios over their wages, royalty payments, and the use of artificial intelligence.
The bosses, management, corporations, they must share the wealth that we helped create. They must share it properly, fairly, and until they do, we will hold the line.
But the writers may not be alone for much longer, as SAG-AFTRA, which represents actors and actresses, has also voted to authorize a strike. Yahtzee, which handles crews and the Directors Guild of America, is also nearing contract negotiations.
It's like already tough in normal times and it's just only getting worse, so we got to stop it now before things just get out of control with AI and streaming and all the ways that we're getting taken advantage of, all of us.
In sports, Filipino boxer Melvin Jerusalem went to Indio, California with big dreams and the WBO minimum flyweight world title. He fought until he could no longer get up from his stool. The Bukidnon fighter lost his WBO belt to Puerto Rican Oscar Collazo via technical knockout in the 7th round.
Nauna, mga 1, 2, 3, okay pa naman. Pero para hindi na ako nakagalaw ng mga ilang round. Para kulang talaga sa adjustment, guys. Sorry talaga, binigay ko na yung best.
Jerusalem started the night patiently throwing jabs and landing a few combinations in the early rounds. However, Collazo found his opening, landing body shots and throwing combinations, putting Jerusalem in trouble from round 4 onwards. And finally, Phil-Am coach Eric Spoelstra and the Miami Heat avoided being on the wrong side of history by making it to their second NBA Finals appearance in 4 years. The Heat beat the Boston Celtics in Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Finals, 103-84. The Heat jumped out to a 3-0 lead before the Celtics managed to win 3 straight games and force a Game 7. Jimmy Butler led the Heat with 28 points and won the Bill Russell Eastern Conference Finals MVP award. The Heat is the first 8th seed to advance to the finals since the New York Knicks advanced in the lockout-shortened 1999 season. Game 1 of the finals tips off in Denver on Thursday night. This is the 6th time in 15 seasons that Spoelstra has led the Heat to the NBA Finals, winning back-to-back championships in 2012 and 2013.
It's hard to survive 3 rounds just to get to that final round. We're extremely grateful for that. We're not even going to think about this next round until we get to Denver.
And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News, and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Stay with us, Kapa Media.
I'm Romel Clara, and this is your TFC News Now. We begin in Canada's Northwest Territories in Hay River, where the wildfires are still raging, but it is now categorized as being held or not likely to grow. The fire has destroyed more than 3,000 hectares of land and has damaged at least 15 buildings in the Katladeche First Nation. After almost 2 weeks, evacuees were allowed to come back to Hay River, except those who live in the reserve where the fires are still active. Among those who returned home were 25 Filipino families. Several days before they left, they were all invited to a luncheon by the Philippine Cultural Association of Yellowknife.
This is actually the Filipino Cultural Association's way of showing our solidarity and acknowledging our Hay River Kababayans that no matter where they are, and we know that they're having some challenges right now, that we're here to support them.
In sports, the NBA Finals tip off on Thursday night in Denver. Filipino-American Eric Spoelstra has once again led the Miami Heat to the NBA Finals for the 6th time in his head coaching career, as Mike Malone has brought the Denver Nuggets to their first NBA Finals appearance. Prior to tip-off, analysts Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy, who will be calling the finals for ABC, share their thoughts on Spoelstra's achievements.
The ability of Pat Riley, for whatever reason, to handpick Eric Spoelstra. He saw something, and it was an incredible pick by Pat Riley. And the job that Eric Spoelstra has done consistently through peaks and valleys, through being the favorite with a big three that matches, any in the history of the game, to struggling at times and not making the playoffs, but being consistent as a leader, being consistent as a worker, being consistent as a motivator has been inspiring for anybody across sports.
He's a Hall of Fame coach, the best coach in Miami Heat history, obviously, like 6 finals, 2 championships, and I marvel at what he's been able to accomplish.
Spoelstra, who has been with the Heat organization for 28 years before becoming head coach in 2008, is the second longest tenured head coach in the league. And finally, students and residents of Harvard Square got a taste of Filipino food and they loved it. They lined up to get a bite of the flavorful Filipino barbecue and all-time favorites like adobo and lechon. There was something for everyone at the first ever Asian Street Food Festival in Cambridge, Massachusetts.
My favorite Filipino food, I'd say lumpia, pancit. She makes all sorts of stuff.
Many couldn't wait to try Filipino desserts made of the Philippine purple yam or ube.
I do like ube ice cream. It's very refreshing. Want to just check out all the food here.
And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TSC news on the ABS-CBN News website, news.abs-cbn.com/TSC News, and on the ABS-CBN YouTube channel. Stay with us, Kapa Media.
I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin in Toronto, where Filipinos welcomed the new Consul General, Angelica Escalona, who pledges to strengthen ties between the Philippine government and Filipino communities in Canada. Escalona began her diplomatic career as a Foreign Service Officer at the Philippine Department of Affairs more than 25 years ago. During the gathering, Filipinos raised some pressing concerns, including the challenges of migrant workers and caregivers in Canada and the high dropout rates among Filipino teens.
My priorities during my assignment here in Toronto basically are three. First is the further improvement of our consular services here at the consulate. I'm actually looking at the implementation of e-payment or payment by credit card for our consular services. Second is active engagement with all of you on activities of relevance and importance to you. And my final priority is to aim for closer cooperation with the officials, the private sector, and the people of Canada.
Meanwhile, officials from Pangasinan, Philippines, were recently given a tour of the Daly City water facilities. From there, the group was sent to City Hall to get a personal look at how the San Francisco Bay Area city, which is home to many Filipinos, operates. Philam Daly City Mayor Ray Buenaventura calls this meeting a new relationship with different cities and provinces in the Philippines.
We are making sure that we reach out to as many people as we can and that are willing to form a relationship with us.
This was inspired by our governor, Governor Ramon Gigo III, to promote the convergence.
The visit was also made possible by the San Francisco-based United Pangasinanes of America. And finally in sports, the Miami Heat and the Denver Nuggets held their meet today at the Ball Arena in downtown Denver, ahead of Game 1 of the NBA Finals on Thursday night. Head coach Eric Spoelstra and the Miami Heat have defied the odds all season, battling injuries and tough losses, eventually entering the playoffs as an 8th seed before taking out two teams in the Eastern Conference.
This league is so fragile. It is so tough, you know, to go through the gauntlet. Not only just a regular season, 82 games, you know, 5.5 months, but then to go through the gauntlet of 3 7-game series just to get to this point.
This is the 6th NBA Finals appearance for Spoelstra in his 15 years as head coach. The Filipino-American won 2 championships as a head coach and a 3rd as an assistant. Standing in the Heat's way are the Denver Nuggets, who have the best record in the West and have been in more than a week's rest.
They're more of a gritty defensive team throughout the season, and we're more of an offensive powerhouse throughout the season. And I think it's going to be a fun series.
And those are the news-making headlines today. Catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News. And on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Stay with us, Kappa Media.
I'm TJ Manotok, and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin in Washington, D.C., where the U.S. Senate on Thursday passed bipartisan legislation backed by President Joe Biden that lifts the government's $31.4 trillion debt ceiling into 2025 and cut the deficit, sending the bill to President Joe Biden's desk. This averted what would have been a historic first-ever default.
On this vote, the yeas are 63, the nays are 36. The 60-vote threshold having been achieved, the bill is passed.
The Senate voted 63 to 36 to approve the bill that was passed on Wednesday by the House of Representatives following months of arguing between Democrats and Republicans. The Treasury Department was at risk of being unable to pay all of its bills on June 5 had Congress failed to reach an agreement. Meanwhile, it was high energy in the Mile High City as the Denver Nuggets put on a dominant Game 1 win, beating the Miami Heat 104-93 in the NBA Finals.
We've done a hell of a job all season long of protecting our home court. I don't think we've lost a game at home in the playoffs as of yet.
Two-time MVP Nikola Jokic became the first player since Jason Kidd in 2002 to record a triple-double in their Finals debut. As Jokic scored 27 points and Jamal Murray put in 26, Miami came out shooting cold, finishing with a 40.6% field goal percentage. The Heat trailed by as much as 24 points in the second half. Despite the rough start, Miami head coach Eric Spoelstra believes the team improved in the second half.
We're in a pretty good rhythm, especially in that first half. Our disposition, the multiple efforts, the resolve in the second half is much better.
The Heat will get their chance to tie up the series when Game 2 takes place in Denver on Sunday. And finally, we go to Smyrna, Georgia, where Filipino nurses took break from work to showcase their talents. In the first ever Nurses Got Talent event.
There's a lot of nurses out there who has talents, right, that they don't show. They're just shy and they don't want to go out of their way to show their talent.
It paid off for Ria Ruel, who took the top prize for her singing performance. Organizers say the friendly competition is their way of celebrating and honoring all the healthcare workers for all their sacrifices, especially amid the pandemic.
And those are our headlines for today. Catch more of our TFC News online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. I'm DJ Manotok. Stay with us, Kapamilya.